Hey everybody, this is going to be a test of an AMSICO horn, basically AMSICO slash Mercom remote horn. This is a horn only version of those horn strobes that you would see, I believe, in Canada, mostly. Or of course, they're in America, which I saw a horn strobe at a Sheetz in Dillsburg, Pennsylvania. This is an AMSICO HW-24. Select a horn. And it has a couple of tones. You got here non-temporal, temporal, electromechanical, 3000 hertz, high or low volume. And of course, I'm going to change it to low volume for this test. I see another brand here, Kobishi, and I'm thinking this might be an original brand to whoever made this alarm, or maybe AMSICO bought this brand. But as we all know, this is an AMSICO Mercom alarm, and these stickers were added on. So you could have it as a ceiling mount, or you could have it as a wall mount, of course. But wouldn't look good if you had the other fire lettering, of course. But for me, my purpose, you can have it either way. Alrighty, so I went ahead and did some for you guys that you guys may really enjoy. And it is the dissection of this AMSICO horn, in which in horn strobes you probably see the same. But, of course, you would see the components in a different, like, form. There you go. So this is the entire circuitry. There is actually multiple integrated circuits here. There's multiple capacitors. You have resistors, diodes, and then right here in this section is where the other side of the jumpers, the jumper metal conductors are. And then there's copper twine. And then you have your piezo that does multiple tones. It does look again like a smoke detector piezo, which mainly it is. But of course, there's the ability for electromechanical in this device. So, of course, you have like some different tones. Nothing else to see. Not really anything else to see, except here, I guess, everything in this section, as there's nothing, not even any solder, I guess this is where the strobe components would have been, in these areas. And over here, I guess, is where all the components are for the horn, since there's no strobe, which is around this section here. But anyways, this is always really cool to see what's inside these devices, regardless if it's a horn or a strobe or a horn strobe. Like, this is just really cool. But anyways, put it back together and we'll give it a test on low volume. And I'll start with temporal of both. This one, you have to wait like 5 to 10 seconds for it to then sound, which is kind of interesting, but oh well. And in addition, your 3000 hertz, this one here seems to not have the fluctuation of sound. It's just a constant, continuous sound instead, if you know what I mean. As you heard this similar device with other folks, you heard like a flutter instead of just a continuous sound on your 3000 hertz. But you'll see in a moment. All right, so here is 3000 hertz temporal. Here is electromechanical in code 3. This still does sound different than the 3000 hertz. All right, here's 3000 hertz continuous. And last but not least, electromechanical continuous. All right, and that's all the functions. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out.